Start, there's just a couple things you have to remember. Number one, you have to remain calm, right? And number two, you have to show no fear.
Teach it.
Because the sharks, you see, the sharks, they can sense that fear just as easily as they can sense blood. And so it went for me, just as I knew it would, just as nature had ordained its jaw wide open, row upon row of these razor-sharp teeth glinting underwater like jagged diamonds, its tail fin sweeping back and forth as it surged in for the kill. I swear to God, my whole life flashed before my eyes. Really, I had nothing left to offer except for pure reflex. Pure reflex. And mankind's basic drive for survival that somehow shouts, "No! I will not die today!" And at that instant, man, I knew it was either the shark or me. The shark knew it. I knew it. Oh, geez, God. It's nothing personal, right? You know, it's just the way the world works, right? It's nature. But if I remember correctly, in that last glimmer of its eyes, there was a moment between us where he said, "Hey, Richard, man, enjoy your dinner."
Killing a shark, isn't it, Richard?
Just a big fish, Bugs.
Just a big fish? Yeah, maybe. Maybe when it's just a baby and it hasn't really learned to kill yet, then maybe it's just a big fish. But when it's a great white angry mother with a taste of human blood on its tongue, well, that's a different story.
For a while, we were untouchable in our happiness.
But some of you may have heard, a couple of sacks of rice have become contaminated by a fungus. Which means that someone will have to come to Copenhagen with me to buy some rice.
Richard?
Yeah.
You're going to come to Copenhagen with me?